sun is up, the sky is blue, it's beautiful, and so are you, dear Prudence. Won't you come out to play?
You know how the song grows into this big feeling? You know, look around, round, round. It's like as if you're on a flying saucer. And she's still in this closet in the middle, and the world is spinning around, and then it evolves that this world spinning is the Fifth Avenue March. I don't know how we're doing this. I just, you know, who's the special effects guy? Where is he? No makeup.
Who are we looking for?
Come on.
I wanted to be in the movies.
You know, they say don't work with children, animals,
or
Irish rock stars.
Or Irish rock stars, okay.
Julie Taymor, I think, is just a very rare kind of a figure in popular culture because she has the sensibilities of a fine artist. And yet, I think she kind of gets it on the more immediate front. And, you know, she doesn't disappear up her or anyone else's arses for too long, you know. And that's rare around here, so I'm interested in anything she does.
Action.
One wheel on my wagon, I'm still rolling along. The house of Dr. Geary. We're navigators, aviators, we're eating taters, masturbating alligators, bombardiers, cosmic explorers, pushing the frontiers of transcendental perception.
Julie Taymor has such incredible vision. Everybody wants to work with Julie Taymor, with good reason. And so she's been able to attract, you know, incredible artists, you know, from the visual effects to Bruno Del Bonnel, who's our DP, to Mark Freeberg, who's our production designer, to, you know, Albert Wolski, who's our unbelievable costume designer. I mean, across the board, everybody wants to work with her, and because she has, you know, such amazing talent. And she's able to be a beacon for all these other artisans to come together.
Julie is probably the most creative director that I've ever worked with. Each morning when we come in, she has a vision that I've never seen anyone have before. And she creates things, it's like discovery is happening around us all the time. And you can almost see these things developing as they happen. And sometimes it's really good and sometimes it's very difficult.
Guys.
Danielle, are we missing a cow skirt for these two guys?
Don't stop the shot, just because it's Maddie. You're missing one cow.
All right, thanks.
It's come to this.
Having said that, what she ends up getting on film is amazing.
We've got a duet where one person is in Vietnam and Jude is at home creating these incredible paintings. How do you make a duet where two people are not together? And we actually took our footage of Jude singing Strawberry Fields and projected it in the camera onto the face of Max. So we have a duet. This is not a visual effect happening later. We shot it live. And we're all going, look at this. You've got helicopters are going over the nose and under the nose of Max. And all of a sudden, Jude's there throwing paint. And this came spontaneously. This came from being open at that moment to, let's just, you know, what is it Mickey Rooney says? Let's put on a show. We're making a musical that didn't exist, though we were blessed with 200 songs of the Beatles to choose from. And Dick and Ian and myself went through this incredible catalog of songs and created a story inspired by those songs.
Julie came in like a whirlwind and she had a whole raft of ideas.
And that's when we threw away the first pages we'd written. We thought, you know, there's no way you can corral or compete with this mind. You can argue with it a few times, give her another mojito and we might win an argument, but I think she's also a person, when you work with her for a while, you know that whatever journey you go on, no one's gonna work harder.
So what we all feel that we're trying to do here is to create a musical that feels as if those songs emerge from the characters.
Revolution, well, you know.
songs are forwarding the action and they're forwarding the emotions. They're not laid on top. And that, in a certain way, is a very old-fashioned musical. It's like an opera. It's really coming at that moment.
When we talk about destruction, don't you know that you can count me out?
What the hell are you doing here, friend?
Not the time. Not
you
now.
Know it's gonna be.
We're not doing a history musical, but we are really inspired by the events of the 60s. It's an image that we're looking back to, but it reflects what's happening now in an interesting way. There's prisons where we have to look at where people are trying to still change the world.
For Julie, she left the U.S. when she was very, very young to travel, go to Indonesia, Asia. And she then saw a different world in Indonesia as a way of expressing some of her own personal talents through certain Asian techniques and seeing the world objectively. Now she's looking at that time, her own world, as almost another culture, as an objective thing.
With Julie, it's a fluid process. It's not written on the page. This is what we do. There's a discussion. There's an evolution. In this case, the idea that we had for creating this world was this would be just an explosion of emotion, explosion of color, so that by the time the young people get here, they can really let go.
We are people now. We're artists now. So it's through our mind's eye or our vision of how that period speaks to us now.